My PSA to the industry and to everybody else is that I'm not high all day long. I do smoke and joke a lot, but there is a good amount of time that my clients demand me to be sober. So therefore, I am sober. Anybody that's trying to do what you gotta do to get into this industry, try to remain sober during the days, get fucked up at night. You know what I mean? Get titties like this thrown at you. Let's go. All these motherfucking flashing lights on me, cameras and shit. I feel like the artist, kid. My first job in the industry was actually working for Bad Boy, doing the marketing and shit, like throwing their parties and stuff like that. And, you know, it was a good learning experience, but it really just wasn't for me working for anybody. So I left Bad Boy just leaving. I didn't want to be there. Not in a bad way, but just I'm not good at taking orders. Like, I never was in school or anything, class clown since 1980. And I basically just fucking left and was like, I'm gonna try and make it in music. Hopefully some shit pops off for me. If it doesn't, then, you know, I'll hustle doing something else. But I left with nothing, to be honest with you. It was just like, I left with like a dollar and a dream, man. It was just a dollar and a dream.
Dollar.
Yeah, we're doing an interview for HBO right now.
Great.
So if you want to shout anything out real quick,
hell yeah.
Well, hurry up, because this interview is about me, not you, motherfucker.
What up, yo, Cuzzin Todd? I'm gonna look fresh in this motherfucker, you know what I mean?
I like that. I like the tucked in look. Keep it. Keep it, and we're
you know,
in green.
Gucci Lowe's,
and we're both in
belt.
Green, and we're both in
how
green.
That's how we do over here. You know, Cuzzin Todd, I'm in the fucking build. Well, I can't curse.
No, it's HBO.
Oh, yeah, good curse. All right, my bad, take it back. Cuzzin Todd, I'm in the fucking building. But shout out to my brother Jonny Shipes, my big brother right here. This is the biggest dude in the music industry in my eyes and a lot of other people's eyes.
What are you rocking today?
Good talk, you fucking pricks.
You look magnificent.
I'm rocking, you know, straight out of Neiman's, you know, Gucci Los, Gucci Belt. That's how I do, man. Conduct big meetings all day.
Put your hand out of my face. You're like, oh, my face. Oh. You're ruining my look.
Oh, okay. You want me to make up?
No. Sean Kingston. I got a phone call from Zach Katz. Shout out to Zach. And basically they just, he was like, yo, you gotta hear this kid, he's amazing. I went out there, listened to him, he was very talented. Sean started as a rapper. He was rapping, literally like rapping, and then he just came in the studio one day and was like singing patois. That was the thing about him, he always, he was just so focused, always music, it was music, music, music. He'd be at the hotel at fucking, you know, 8 a.m., 9 a.m. waking me up, or Dizza up, or whoever was out in Cali at the time. I can't really take credit for shit like that, because you never know what's gonna be big or not.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't know he was gonna be big. He just happened to blow up, and I was lucky enough to be involved with it. I was like looking for a specific thing. I always love West Coast music, and I just asked Felly, I was like, there's gotta be something out on the West Coast that's phenomenal. And he was like, yo, there's this kid, Nipsey Hussle, and then, you know, I went home to New York City. I actually didn't meet him when I was out in LA. I went home, listened to him. He was dope as fuck. Reached out to Steve Lobel and Big U, who were managing him at the time. And we set up the meeting. I went out there, flew out there, and like, we literally closed the deal like ASAP. It's a very, very long story, but the long story short is basically nobody knew what the fuck they were doing at the major, which for the majority of the time is basically how all these labels operate. And we had gotten Nipsey to such a swell where like he was really blowing up, like everybody was talking about him, you know, the resurrection of the West Coast, this, that, and the third. And Epic was just looking at us like it wasn't even on the map. They were like, no, like this single's whack. And we had good records, like Nip was making good records, you know? And they just like forced shit down his, you know, for him to do that he necessarily didn't want to. And it was just a mess. Epic doesn't do urban. They may do it now very well. I don't know. You know, this was 5 years ago or 4 years ago. I just can't fuck with the majors, man. Shout out to them. I respect them all, whatever. But it's a new day and age. And honestly, like, I'm not disrespecting them, so like don't shut down my operation or anything, please. But I just can't fuck with it. I'd rather just, I've learned over the past few years, happiness is way more important to me than like, you know, being the highest on the totem pole at Universal here. And that's what I used to think was what I wanted or whatever. It's not, so I don't know. I just don't like the majors. It doesn't really make me happy. I can't make my own decisions. I can't, you know, my artists have no real creative integrity aside from like a little bit. It's just what. No, 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 no.